In order to have touch inputs when you're interacting with your stream on a touch-enabled device, you will need to enable the following touch-related settings. So start by opening your player controller, and in the Details panel, tick Enable Touch Events. Once you have enabled the touch events, you can now add the blueprint functionality responsible for handling the touch input. The main touch node you'll be concerned with is the input touch node. This node drives all of the touch functionality we have in our Arcware pawn. This node is often combined with a switch on touch index node to allow you to trigger different events depending on which finger is currently being pressed. Some additional nodes you should be aware of are get hit result under finger, either by collision channel or by object. And also, if we go into edit, project settings, input, you can activate enable gesture recognizer, which, if we then come back to the blueprint, gives you access to these dedicated gestures, the flick, pinch, and rotate. Now, the touch functionality in Unreal Engine seems to have many issues when it comes to iOS devices. We are still looking into why this is happening, but it even occurs when using the pixel streaming infrastructure from Epic directly. So all of these touch nodes work fine on Android, but not on iOS devices, which has forced us to avoid using these nodes and instead build workarounds using the input touch node only. For example, this get hit result under finger node should, as it states, give reference to whatever actor we are currently touching on the screen. But as this doesn't work on iOS, we made the following workaround. We use the touch input node, then manually check the screen location of the currently pressed finger, then convert the 2D location to a 3D world space. Then using the forward vector, we shoot out a line trace from the finger location to see which actor we are interacting with. This workaround seems to work fine on iOS currently, but we will of course be refactoring the input logic when new techniques are presented. So, because of these touch input workarounds currently being required to use your stream on iOS devices, we highly recommend to download our template project and take a look at how we've set up our own player pawn. So if we open up the pawn, I'll show you one quick example. As you can see here in our zoom logic, it's how we set up the pinch gesture to work originally. And then above that, there's the workaround we built instead that works on iOS, which can be seen here. So all these custom nodes are doing is taking the initial screen location from finger 1 and finger 2, and then comparing if the fingers moved closer together or further apart to decide how much to zoom the camera in or out. Additionally, we will be making a deep dive video on how the Arcware pawn was set up, but that will be covered in a separate tutorial series due to the amount of features that need to be talked about in the pawn. Two other touch functions to be aware of under project settings input are the always show touch interface and use mouse for touch options. Firstly, if you show the touch interface, you'll be provided with some on-screen joysticks when you play the game. So I'll just play the game and show you. So you see here, you have a left and right joystick, meaning that if you have a project which is something like a first-person shooter where you need to move both the camera and the character independently, then these joysticks can be helpful to control both movements whilst on a touch device. If you're unsure how to utilize the input from these virtual joysticks, you can open up the touch interface here, navigate to it in the project, and you can see in here which inputs the joysticks are actually controlling. So it's going to drive the gamepad left thumbstick axis, meaning if I come now to my player pawn, I can add the gamepad left thumbstick axis in here and use this to drive whatever player movement you need. So if we come back to the project settings, the second setting I mentioned is the use mouse for touch. Now, this is just a handy feature for debugging touch inputs if you don't have a touch device available to you. All it does is simulate the touch events by triggering it via the mouse instead. So you can check if your touch logic is working without having a touch device connected. So you can see here, when it's disabled and I left click in the viewport, the input is being triggered via left mouse. And then when I enable it and click in the viewport again, it will trigger touch one instead. So as you can see, it might be useful to you, but just don't forget to disable it when uploading your project, because it is only a debug feature for touch. If your Unreal Engine project is prepared to receive touch inputs, you will also need to log into CloudRT, go to your project settings, and in there you need to specify that your project uses touch inputs by enabling the touch capability setting. So that was the final step for enabling touch in your project, and you can continue to the next lesson.